Now, when data analysts are working with data sets or they're running something, running a piece of analysis with a new data set, they may discover that there are data quality issues with the data. So, for example, where there should be values, it might be null, or where there's dates, the dates may be in another format, and so they can't really analyze it. So they start to fix it, or they think they can start to fix it. But data analysts and data scientists, what they like to do is automate tasks. So they'll go in and they think, okay, let's try and automate the fixing of these data issues. So let's say you've got a date range and typically it's, let's say, DD, MM, YYYY, and suddenly they see some that are MM, DD, YYY, they might write a code and go, blah, 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 let's write this code and fix the date issue into the format that we need. But sometimes the date issue might be DD, and then MMM, so like 29th of April, APR, rather than 04, and then year, okay? And so therefore, the code doesn't pick it up, and there may be not enough instances of these, and if you're working with millions of rows of data, you can't visually inspect it. So because this is time consuming, they may either just ignore that data, so they go, you know what, it's only 3-4% or 5%, I'm just gonna delete it. In fact, it might even be 20%, and they go, I'm not gonna use it, so they just like ignore it in their analysis, and they think 80% is big enough, and they use that, or they include it in the analysis and it just gets integrated because the algorithm will run if you tell it to just do it, right? Okay, the algorithms that you run don't actually care what data you're running it on, it will just run it, okay? So what may happen is that you either end up with a model with not 100% of the data, or analysis with not 100% of the data, or analysis with data with errors in it, okay? Now, unless you know what all the data quality issues are, you're going to accept the findings. And so because these things take time, the data analyst just doesn't bother with that. And so what I find is that when you're working with new data sets, that you have to tell data analysts to care about that. Now, there may be 5% of data that's not usable, okay? But that 5% could represent a specific group, like for example, a very high value group in your data set that could impact your findings, or a particular segment of your audience that could impact the findings. So ignoring it is not a good thing, as is not including poor quality data into your model, because you'll end up with a finding that's not accurate. When you do have data analysts that are interested in fixing the problem, okay, because like I said, it's time consuming, they'll go to their business and they'll say, oh, look, I found all these data issues, I think we should fix them. The organization might just say, look, we haven't got the time for this. We haven't got the time, the money, the resource for this. Just run the model, do what you can, okay? And so therefore the data analyst just carries on doing what they're doing, because if the business is not gonna support them, they don't wanna waste their time doing this activity that's not gonna be recognized. And so what they do is just, they just carry on, and as I mentioned before, either ignore the data or include the poor quality data into the analysis. Now, one of the reasons the data analyst doesn't want to do this and the organization doesn't value this is that it's because it's hidden effort. And what I mean by that is when you work on data quality, no one actually sees it, okay? No one actually sees what you're doing, because it's not the output. It is the groundwork, the foundation for you to do good analysis. So it's a bit like having a building, right? Nobody sees the foundation, but a lot of work goes into establishing the foundation, because if you don't have a good foundation in the building, the rest of the building, when you build it up, won't be stable. And it's the same with data. If you don't have a good foundation, then the rest of it is not stable. But because it's hidden, a lot of the data analysts don't want to be working on that, because it means that if they spent 4 or 5 weeks on that, no one's going to recognize it. They're not going to understand what they're getting for it. And especially if you say, look, I spent 4 or 5 weeks of an 8-week project or a 12-week project fixing a 5% issue, a 10% issue, they're going to be like, why did you bother? You've got great data on the rest of the 90, 80%, whatever. But they won't understand that poor quality data could represent something significant in the business. And you won't know that until you fix it, or until you clean that data. And then finally, one of the reasons that data analysts don't get involved, and especially data scientists don't get involved in fixing the data quality issues, is they don't think it's their role, okay? They may think it's the data engineer's role, they may think it's actually the source system, the people who design the source system, so it might end up being the developers, the product managers who should be correcting at the source system. But the data analysts and the data scientists may not believe, or do not believe, that it's their role to fix the data issues. Now, like I said, they may do some ad hoc automation to fix some of the issues just to get their analysis done, but they won't fix the core problem. problem because they don't see it as part of their role. If you're a data analyst and data scientist and you come across this issue where there's poor data quality, and even though it may be small, it could have an impact on your analysis, what I would suggest is that you raise it with the business, you flag it, and then if you they still make you do the analysis, they still say to you, I still want the analysis, then you put it down as an assumption or a limitation of the analysis. So when you do your report or your presentation, you in the first few slides, you say, look, when I did an exploratory data analysis or a data audit, I found that they're on these columns, let's say, you know, date of birth, or I found on gender or something, fields that shouldn't be in that column, and that represents 1%, 10%, whatever percent, 20%. I mean, I've worked with data where 40% of the data has been really poor. So you just flag it and you say, look, these are the number of columns that I looked at, I audited or I ran an exploratory data analysis, and the quality of the data is not good. So, you know, I am putting these as caveats, as limitations, and now I'm going to show you the presentation just to bear in mind that if those assumptions, those caveats, those limitations have an impact, then my analysis will not be as robust as it should be. Okay? That way the business knows that you warned them about the issue, that they've understood that there is an issue, but they still want you to do the analysis. Well, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it informative. Please do like and share the video, and please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.